Do you want to live up to your fullest potential and make sure that you can enjoy life at the highest quality possible? If so, you need to start taking more ownership than you've ever done in your past life. You really need to start stepping up as the full captain of your ship, the person who is driving your life in the right direction. When I became a coach, this was exactly what I wanted my clients to understand. I really cannot believe how much human potential there is out there, but how much sometimes we forget about it and how much we sometimes just go through the motion and, you know, stay victim of our circumstances or whatever is happening to us without us really being fully in control, fully in charge of what's happening. And it's very important not taking ownership completely, not being aware that you can take ownership in some areas of your life is probably what is costing you right now some lack of confidence, some lack of happiness and joy in general, and some lack of fulfillment in specific areas where you know that there is more for you waiting. And don't get me wrong, taking ownership is a very complicated thing. It's a tedious process. You need to show up and do the work every day. It requires some very, very strong honesty. It requires you to go and do the deep digging work of awareness to know exactly what's going on in a specific area of your life where you don't feel right now you have control. What could have been the reason? What are your past behaviors and past actions that have created this situation? You need to go in it with full honesty, with full compassion as well. And then obviously you need to start taking accountability for it, start taking actions to make sure that it is changing. It's a tedious process, but think about it. Is it not that much better than actually just being a victim or just feeling that everything goes out of control every time, or just staying in a mode where you get derailed by people, by someone making a comment to you, by a negative emotion you are getting? Think about all of these things that you think that you don't have ownership on that you could actually claim ownership for. Would it not be like amazing to do that? I think it is. And as I was telling you, this is a very complex process. And I really want you to know there are actually a couple of areas where if you start taking ownership, like real ownership, where you really start focusing on taking actions and really go and do the work, you are going to see massive improvements straight away. And I want to share with you these three areas because they are the one I want you as your coach, giving you this video today to make sure that you are going to start paying attention more. The first one, it is the most fundamental one, is your inner world. Whatever is happening within your brain is under your control. Whatever is passing in your brain is under your control. And if you let this inner world impact whatever you are going to do outside of it, you are going to not feel in control at all. So couple of things that you cannot really influence: thoughts and emotions. These are quite automatic reactions to whatever is happening in your environment, whatever other people are saying to you, whatever feedback you are receiving from the outer world. But the interpretation you do from these thoughts, the moods you create from these feelings, the feelings you create as well, everything that is making you think, everything where you have a power to interpret differently, a power to take another decision, a power to put another intention or whatever you are understanding from the situation is under your control. So this is really something where you need to go and have a look and kind of do your emotional cleanup, your intellectual cleanup, whatever it is for you. But if you see, if you're a person who has very, very strong challenges in this area, so if you say you've been experiencing anger patterns or anxiety patterns very, very strongly for a while and you have not found the solutions yet, you might need to go and talk to someone who is specialized in this area that can really help you. If you say, you know what, I'm quite okay in my head, but from time to time, there is, you know, this person is always annoying me, or I always end up in this type of situation and I always feel a low confidence because of it, or you know that there are a couple of things that are triggering you quite often, there is something behind that you can do. There is work that you can go and do. Sometimes it will be mindfulness practices. Sometimes it will be just reframing beliefs that you have around situations. Sometimes it's just going to go and have a stronger sense of emotional intelligence. So really connecting with your emotions and putting a different meaning on whatever you are feeling. There is work that you can do there to just make sure that your inner world is as healthy as possible. And taking ownership of it is really starting from you. It's from you saying, you know what? I want to be the brain of my own brain. I want to be the person who is actually controlling what's happening there because I realize this is really impacting me out there and I know it's not helping me being my most successful person. So have a look at your inner world first and really make sure that this is as healthy as possible and as You are as connected as possible with it so that you can understand and put your own meanings about things. The second big area where you're going to see massive changes whenever you start taking, start being the captain of it, is how you spend your resources. And the resources that I'm talking about here are the two most precious ones that you have, is your time and your energy. These two are limited. They need to be protected. They need to be defended. They need to be spent in the best possible things for you to bring this sense of quality in your life. If you are not paying attention, people are going to steal it from it, steal it from you. They are going to steal it. Events are going to steal it. So be very mindful of how you are connecting with your time. What are you doing with it? Are you working on productive actions? Are you working towards your bigger vision? Are you paying attention to things that are actually meaningless, who are actually making you feel emotionally depleted and impacting your own inner world as well? Are you focusing on spending time and energy on your personal growth instead of just comparing yourself to other people around there? Are you spending time on recharging and being proactive with your health, with your wellness in general, which is one big area that can really support you to get the high quality of life you want? What's happening in your environment? Do you have the right people? Do you have the right thing entering your environment? So really have a look at where does your time and your energy go right now. If you cannot tell me, I'm the person in control of my time right now. If you cannot tell me, I know exactly where my energy is going, there is work for you to do there. If you can tell me where it's going right now, but you're like, I don't like it, time for you to claim it back. Time for you to go and put some boundaries. Time for you to reshuffle your agenda, to review your wellness practices, to make sure that you are actually in control. And this is going to impact you like straight away. Become more productive and more energetic, the two biggest gifts you can do to yourself. So go and have a look for resources. And the last area that is also very important to take ownership of is your external interactions. So basically, once you've got your inner world fixed or cleaned up, as I was saying, you have more control as well on what you can go and put out there in the world. And again, whatever you put out there in the world is perfectly under your control. You can decide to react to someone making a negative comments about you, or you can decide to ignore. You can decide to treat someone in a rude way because you're having a bad mood that day. You can decide to spend your day complaining because something bad happened to you, or you can decide to step up into your most resourceful personality and just do the work. You have choices on how you interact with others, how you treat others, how do you act, how do you show up, how do you speak up for yourself, what do you do as well in terms of courage. Every action you take out there, everything you say out there, every reaction you have towards your environment is under your control. And the more you can keep yourself aligned versus your own values, the more you can say, okay, when I have my best day, this is my standards, this is my values. I really want you to think, are you taking ownership every day to live up to them? Or are you getting through the moods of the day and then behaving in ways that you know are not you, that you know are not respectful to your towards your own values, that are not respectful towards others? Really have a look. Are you apologizing when you are screwing up? Yes? No? Yes? Are you really taking responsibility for your communication? Are you really trying to be the most resourceful person? If you cannot answer yes to all of that, means that there is still work you can do on your external interactions. So this, I would really recommend you to have a think. What are your values? What are the things that you really want to behave out every day? So how do you want to, just behave yourself every day? What is your non-negotiable attitude? That is really going to help you to guide your external interactions. And again, it comes back from having done your inner world work first, because once you get ownership of your inner world, you can go out there in the world in a much more relaxed, much more fulfilled way, much more joyful way already. That is going to impact as well whatever you have in your external interactions. But you still need to take responsibility for whatever you are putting out there, what you are role modeling, and how you are impacting others. So these are really the key area. I want you to really start paying attention, go dig in, take responsibility for where you've not done the right things in the past, and change your future. It is not about you blaming yourself for everything. It's about you owning the lessons of the past and owning your future actions. So have a look, do the work, and if you need any support on that, don't hesitate. I'm all in for helping people to take more ownership of themselves this year. I think we all need that after the year we've got in 2020, 2021. So I'm always there for you if you need.